Welcome to Nalla Narasimha Reddy Education Society Group of Institutions. Myself, Kameshwari, Department of Civil Engineering, Geotechnical Engineering, third year, first semester, R18 Regulations. Today, topic, compaction methods, laboratory compaction method and field compaction methods. In laboratory compaction method, also two types, standard compaction method and modified compaction test. In this compaction method, laboratory compaction test provides the basic for determining the present compaction and molding water content need to achieve the required engineering properties and for controlling construction to ensure that the required compaction and water content are achieved. And compaction, the main aim of compaction is to achieve the maximum dry density and attenuate given soil with standard amount of compaction effect. So and this is a compaction protractor compaction test, the mass, hammer, height and drop, number of blows, number of layers, volume of mold are specified. So here standard modified compaction test and then modified compaction test, two tests. So the volume of mold is 1000 centimeter cube and hammer weight was 2.5 kgs and the number of blows required for each layer is 25 blows. Compacted in a mold, 3 to 5 equal layers, 5 layers. Each layer is 25 layers of compaction. The specified test is energy compaction effect. Drop of hammer from the height of drop is 300 mm. So here mold dimensions are clear. The volume of a mold is 1000 centimeter cube and hammer weight is 2.5 kgs and height of drop from hammer is 300 mm. So this is the standard compaction equipment. It consists of a mold with a collar that will be placed on a top of the mold. At the base of the mold, it consists of a plate. It is connected between the mold and plate. So while compaction done, the soil will be come out, will not come out from the mold. That's why you can add the base plate, mold, and this is collar. Height of drop from each layer. This is the overall mold. This is the overall mold and this is the hammer. By using the compaction, weight of hammer is 2.5 kgs. So the layer is a layer by layer compaction from layer to layer. So first of all, we can take the soil sample and then place add the water. So this is the mold. Mold dimensions, collar and a base plate. The connection between the collar, base plate and then mold. So by using a hammer, it will be rise and drop at a height of 300 mm. So the hammer will be totally raised upward and then dropped on this type of mold. So sleeve and rammer. So soil is placed on a by layer compaction completed. Collar will be removed from the mold and that is removed on a top of the surface that is leveled. That is leveled and that will be weighted by using weighing machine. Protractor compaction test is a function of dry density, water content, compaction effect. So soil is different types of soils will be, we can take graduated and presence of clay minerals, etc. In compaction, standard compaction test, the soil is mixed with very amount of water content, like we can take 2%, 4%, 6% and 8%, or otherwise we can take 4% variation. Water may be, we can take 2% variation. Take the 3 kgs of soil sample, and then we can add 3 kgs with 2% of water. So multiplied with water means 2 kgs and 2% of soil. So that is that amount of 3 kgs of soil, we can add 2% of water to the, that particular soil. So some moisture content will be there in the soil content. So that soil will be separate in 3 layers. So that will approximately we can separate into 3 parts. So each part we can add this way. So by layer compaction. So we can separate the overall amount of soil in the 3 parts. That 3 parts, first we can add 1 layer and compacted by using rammer, 2.5 kgs rammer, by properly by all around the area. We can cover the all around the area and compacted properly. After that we can add second layer and then compacted, and add third layer compacted. So that is layer by layer compaction. After that completion of the 3 layers, at the top of the mold it consists of a collar. So why we can provide collar for leveling the soil? Only mold it is not leveled, that's why we can add the provide the collar on the top of the mold. So after completion of the 3 layers, for each layer 25 blows. For each layer we can compacted by 25 layers. After compaction is completed, we can remove the collar from the mold and level the surface. So weighing, this test is minimum we can done 5 to 6 trials. Each layer we can increase the water content. 3 kg soil sample we can take the it will be passed from 4.75 mm, and then take the, by calculating the volume of the mold, we can take the soil sample and then add 2% of soil. We can weight the mold, and then we can add 4% of soil, and then the same procedure will be repeated, separate into 3 parts, and then layer by layer, and then compaction will be done properly. Compaction will be done properly by layer by layer. Layer by layer compaction completed. So top of the layer will be by using spatula we can level the top of the surface. So here we can use water content, compaction effect, type of soil. The soil is mixed with varying amount of water content to achieve the different water content, several samples of the soil sample. So we can trial 5 to 6 trials. But at a different water contents are compacted according to the compaction test specifications. So each layer we can compacted 25 blows. Each layer we can compacted by using 25 blows. Distribute the blows uniformly over the surface and ensure that rammers always falls free and not obstructed. Rammer paper properly compacted. This is suppose we can assume that this is mold. This is mold. So we can compacted properly in all around the area. In all around the area. Otherwise, successive blows only completed in all around the area. First 4 blows, successive blows. So the soil is in a mold will be divided in 3 leaves. 3 leaves. Why? Because of we can take the overall sample in 3 layers, compacted in layer by layer. So please, second quantity must be in mold such that when compacted it occupies the little over 2/3 of the height of the mold. So 2.5 kgs and 25 blows each layer. So take the soil from the field, collect the soil from the field, and then it is sieved by using sieve, 4.75 mm sieve. And then by calculating the volume of the mold, taking the approximately 3 kgs of soil, and then that soil we can take different types of water ratios, that is approximately we can take as 2%, 4%, 6% and 8%. We can take 5 to 6 trials. Na? So first trial we can add 2%. Second trial we can add 4%. third tile we can add 8% and 10% and 12%. Each tile, same procedure. We can take the soil and then add the water and then divide it into three parts and place a soil in a container mold in three layers. In three layers, layer by layer, and the compaction will be done properly all around the mold. Compaction will be very very important. After that completion, so top of the mold will be removed from the mold and then that will be leveled by using spatula. So upper edge of the spatula, and that mold will be taken and weighted. What is the wet weight of the soil plus mold? And some of the soil will be taken on a container for moisture content determination. Some of the soil will be taken and then kept in a oven 24 hours. So wet weight of the soil plus mold will be weighted. So dry unit weight, the formula is unit weight by 1 plus water content. Gamma D is equal to, that means dry unit weight is equal to unit weight by 1 plus moisture content. The unit weight and the actual water content of each compacted sample are measured. The unit weight and the actual water content of each compacted soil are measured. So derive the dry unit weight from the known unit weight and water content, that is equal to known unit weight. Gamma D is equal, dry unit weight is equal to, it is the defined as the unit weight to the small amount of water content. So unit weight by 1 plus water content. So the graph is drawn between water content and dry unit weight. By using this one, we can calculate the optimum moisture content and maximum dry density. We can take the five to six trials. The first trial, second trial, third and fourth, fifth string. Why? Because of we are doing 5 to 6 trials, the curve is came perfectly, and then we can result also come effectively. So at the water content will be increased, density also increased at a particular moisture content. Further, the water content will be increased, dry density will be decreased. Why? Because of we can add the water to the soil. In permeability, like for example, in soil, in rainy season or water maybe season, continuously rain drops on a ground surface over a period of time. So in starting stage, water will be absorbed by soil. Why? Because of soil consist of a permeability. Due to that permeability, water will be infiltrated into ground surface. But over a long period of time, heavy rain. So water will be stagnant on a ground surface. So that will be flooded and then eroded on a soil particles also. Why? Because of capability will be no capability. So soil also consists of some permeability. So in that way also we can pour a water on a in moisture content. Some moisture content will be absorbed. Expulsion of air voice from the soil, and then it gives the strength, and continuously we can compact on a soil, no further decreasing the volume, no increasing the density. That's why increasing the water content certain stage only increased, but further it is not increased density, decreasing the density. So here different diameter of the mold and volume of mold, weight of hammer, and different types of drop hammers, number of blows required, 25 blows, and the number of layers, energy of compaction. So energy of So here we can note that in compaction test, number of layers will be required, volume of the mold, weight of hammer, height of drop, and see what are the sieve size we can use it for. And the modified compaction test we can discuss in next class. So this is the standard protractor test. Thank you.